Good morning, everyone. Very, very silent group this morning. How are you doing? Good? Thank you. It's great to be here. I can't believe it's already been 1 year since the last event, and I'm really glad to be back today. Let me do a short introduction of our story and some lessons that I'd like to give to you as startup companies. A little caveat before I start, I've never founded a company before. I joined Kakao about 3 years ago, and our company was formed 7 years ago. So what I tell you today is the learning that we learned from our company, from my colleagues, so you have to take that with a bit of a grain of salt. So, Kakao, first formed in 2006 as iWe Lab. And just like any other startups, we had just a handful of employees who really love doing what they do, which is making a great service. And there were a lot of sleepless nights, a lot of development work that went through the evening. And during the first year, we spent a whole year trying to develop a web service called Brew.com. It's a social bookmarking service. And I'm sure you've all heard of this service, right? No? No, obviously not, because we didn't get a lot of users. We spent a whole year trying to develop this service, and then when we actually opened the service, nobody really used this service a lot. And so we closed down the service within 3 months of opening, and then we started again. We spent a whole year, another whole year, developing a new service, and we came up with a service called Wizia.com. Now, this, I guess, you've heard of, right? No? No, not one person has used this service? Yeah. I was told we accumulated about 50,000 users. It's a social ranking service where users put up questions, and then users put up answers, and then people vote on which answer they thought was the best answer. And they rank that according to the number of votes that they got. But again, this was a failure. And then in November 2009, the iPhone device was first introduced to Korea. And this really opened up the new smartphone era in Korea. And so we decided to start all over. But with the two failed services in mind, we learned our lessons. We tried things differently. And one of the things that we did differently was to try to listen to our users rather than trying to come up with a service that we thought was good for the users. So user communication was one of the lessons that we learned from our failure. And also another thing was timing. We tried not to spend too much time trying to come up with the ultimate product. You could never come up with a perfect and flawless service. The best you can do is to come up with an idea, roll that out fast onto the market, and then try to listen to your users and update that service. So in March of 2010, we came up with three different services, not knowing which service will be popular in the market. And so Kakao Talk, hopefully everybody uses. Anybody heard of Kakao Ajit? It's a micro blogging service, much like Naver's band service. And then we had Kakao Suda, which was a mobile Twitter service. But within 3 months, it was pretty obvious that people really liked Kakao Talk. And so today, Kakao Talk enjoys 140 million users, with 6.5 million messages being sent out each and every day. And then also, we have an Instagram-like service called Kakao Story, which attracted 10 million users in the first 9 days of launch. And currently it has 58 million users. A year and a half ago, we introduced games, and it was an odd pairing. even looking back, you know, a mobile instant messenger coupled with mobile games was a very odd idea. But for us, it was a huge success. We now have 7 games with more than 10 million downloads and 2 games with over 20 million. And I hope you've all played. No? In the last year, we launched a service called Kakao Group, which is much like Ajit and also our competitor band. And we also have music. It's a bit different from other music services where you can share music with your friends. And those two services have passed the 10 million marker. And so we have a platform which operates, and the centerpiece of this platform is this social graph. And we believe that this social graph is really our key asset. What I mean by social graph is the KakaoTalk friend relationship we have through our service. On average, each KakaoTalk user has about 180 friends. And it is this network of friends through which Anypang hearts were delivered and story invitations flowed through. And so through this social graph, our service has become a platform, a mobile platform, through which different content, different services are being introduced. Enough about ourselves and some lessons that we've learned through our failures and through our success. And the first lesson that I briefly mentioned is that you really need to fail before you succeed. And you have to look at failure as a learning experience. During the first 3 years of our company, when we launched Brew.com, Wizio.com, we really thought that we could come up with the ultimate global service because we had such great people with us. These were really, you know, genius developers, genius service planners. But it's really hard to pinpoint what your users want. And so the best way that we could think of is to actually learn and listen to our users and have them speak out about what they want in their services. And so when we first launched KakaoTalk, we decided to launch that in the shortest amount of time, which was 2 months, and then constantly receive feedback from our users on what kind of features they wanted in that service. And so there was a lot of... Almost all of the features in KakaoTalk are suggestions from our users. And even new services like Kakao Story were suggestions from our users. Taking Story as an example, there was this constant request from our users to allow them to load more pictures, photographs of themselves. Because KakaoTalk, if you remember, it still is, you can upload only one picture of yourself. And I don't know about you guys, but I changed that picture maybe once a year. But there was a user, this lady, she changes her pictures 80 times a day, each and every day. And this was quite surprising for us. And so that eventually led us to coming up with Kakao Story. Kakao Talk being a messenger service, you really can't change that into a photo album. And so we decided to launch a separate service called Kakao Story, which is linked by the Kakao Talk profile page. And so that's how we come up with new services. And that lesson, actually, we would have known had it not been for the first 3 years of failure. So failure is only failure if you let it be failure. If you can take lessons learned from that failure, that would eventually lead you to success. Lesson number two, kind of the same lesson. It's all about the customer. It's all about the users. And there are a lot of companies that stress this and say that they value the customer, that the customer is king. But we really learned the hard way from the first 3 years that you really have to take the guesswork out of providing a service. You really are limiting yourself if you don't really listen to your customers and try to come up with something, a product that you think the customers will like. The best way and the ultimate way is to continuously communicate with your customers, listen to what they have to say, analyze their action patterns and try to reconstruct in your mind what the users want and deliver that to the customers on a regular basis. So it's all about the customers. Don't ever lose sight of the fact that your customers are the key. And lesson number three, it's about the team and not money. This is a lesson that is often lost in the everyday operations of a startup company. Your bank account is drying up. You're hiring more people. And it seems like the most important thing is funding and money. And so you spend most of your time running around trying to draw in investors, and you're always thinking about the next paycheck day. But you really have to focus on the fact that the money doesn't really guarantee success of your service, of your startup company. It's the team. And when I say team, it's not the individual people and what college they graduated from. It's the devotion of the team as a whole, and the synergy that they build in working together as a team, as a company. So you really have to in order to guarantee success, you should spend more time worrying about how you're going to form your team rather than worrying about money and how to get investments from the outside. That's about it, and I think I've finished too fast, but that's about all I have to say. I hope to speak to you more during the panel session later on. Thank you very much.